zijn beide hier, Bas Bloem en Mr. Pelfman. When you made the documentary, what did you know about the disease?
This was 25, 30 years ago, so I was doing it just as a journalist. And it was just an amazing story because these young drug addicts in California came down with the symptoms of a Parkinson's disease, which is an elderly person's disease. And it turned out they'd been taking a bad batch of synthetic drug. And it led to kind of some big breakthroughs in Parkinson's. But this was just a pure journalistic story, you know, a great story for a journalist. And it helped establish my career as a journalist. And then 25 or 30 years later, ironically, I come down with the same disease.
Yeah. Did you? You never think about that, of course. That
no, of all the diseases, I didn't expect to get that one.
Because it was not in your family or nothing?
No, I had no family history.
Nothing at all. So what did the story do to you? I mean, you got really famous because of the story, because of the documentary you made about it. What did it professionally do for you?
Well, it introduced me to a great number of neuroscientists. So when it came round to when I actually got the disease in 2011 and decided to write this book, I had lots of contacts among neuroscientists like Bas Bloom, who already knew the story, you know, who were happy to speak to me. But basically, I'd say it took me a year to process the information of actually getting the disease. Even though I knew a lot about it, I wasn't ready to accept it for about a year. And then I realized it was my destiny to use my training as a science journalist and my insights as a patient to try and explore this malady, which was now my part of my future.
And if you say you didn't accept it, what happened?
Well, you just keep it secret. You know, it's a processing problem. You're just not ready to deal with it. And so you don't tell everybody. You tell your immediate family, but you deny it. You suffer a lot of anger. It's like the stages of remorse and loss.
And when was the moment you decided, okay, I got to write my story down?
Well, I went back to see Bill Langston, who was the neurologist who discovered the frozen addicts, and we spent an afternoon. This is in 2012, about a year after I was diagnosed, and we spent an afternoon talking about all the developments in Parkinson's that had happened since I'd made the frozen addict, and then I decided that was my destiny to write this book.